these particles are about 1,000 times smaller than the width of a hair. I would estimate that we could fit in billions within the big block M behind me.
We just wanted to demonstrate that we can make particles in different complex shape, and we just wanted to show block M as an example. So these are the particles floating on water now.
I think we made probably the world's smallest block M particles. At least we haven't seen anything smaller than these. Block M was obviously one of our favorite particles to make. We've also made all sorts of other shapes, from squares and triangles to star-shaped particles and a range of different shapes. One of the primary applications is in the area of drug delivery, where there's been a lot of work looking at how shapes of different particles can affect whether a cell can uptake those particles or not. We've been looking at drugs that can specifically go and target ovarian cancer cells and kill the harmful cancer cells without affecting any of the remaining cells within the body. By knowing which types of shapes can actually pass through a particular cell membrane, we can easily develop the exact same shape and then incorporate drug molecules within that particle so that once it's ingested by the cell, it can go in and the drug can be released on the inside of the cells, essentially killing that particular cell. The process of making these particles is relatively straightforward. We take a template that has a very low surface energy, essentially it's not wettable by any liquid, and in between we pattern domains that are extremely wettable by other liquids.
So in this technique, I start off with a silicon wafer coated with liquid repellent coating, and then I expose this wafer to UV light. To expose it in the desired patterns, we use a photomask, and we design the photomask depending upon the particle shape and size that we want. We dip this template in different polymer solution, one after another. This allows us to deposit different layers of polymers, one on top of another.
There's no limit really to how many different layers you can have in a single particle based on this technique. Imagine I had to take a drug every day for 10 days. If I had 10 layers within a single particle, I could take a single capsule and have the particles dissociate over 10 days, each day releasing a certain amount of the drug. And so you would only have to remember to take the pill once in 10 days as opposed to every day for 10 days. The other thing that it's really useful for is developing particles that can be targeted to specific areas. So for example, we've incorporated magnetic particles, and so using an external magnet, you can program or you can direct the flow of these particles to any specific area within the body that you would want. No one had really put two and two together and combined these properties of using a very low surface energy material and a high surface energy template on top of it to make particles before us. In terms of next steps for the project, we're working on developing a tool that can be used to automate the entire process, where we'd be essentially able to program in both the shape, size, and the thickness, and we'd be able to make those in a very rapid and automated manner.
The cells seem to have a mechanism that recognizes whether it's in a living human being or not, or whether they're in a healthy or diseased human being or not.